Now, let us have an understanding of the transaction. And that's the option transaction. That is what's the new segment that we are going to start today. And in that, we are going to start with the call option. To explain that, again, I am taking an example like this. Let us say that, on 1st of January, there are two traders, X and Y. Both of them are discussing about the price of the security, let us say, of Tata Consultancy Services after 1 month, that is on 31st of January. Mr. X has certain reasons to believe that the price of the security will be 1800, and Y has certain reasons to believe that the price of the security will be 2200. Both of them are having some discussion. After that, Mr. X offers to Mr. Y that let us enter into a contract in which you purchase security from me at the rate of ₹2000 on 31st of January. Like that, so the X is offering to Y. That's the letter sent into a contract in which we decide the price 2000. That is the price at which you purchase security from me. Mr. X is expecting that the price of the security will be 1800. So he thinks that at 1800 he will buy the security and he will sell the security at 2000. And X believes that the Y would be interested in the transaction because he is expecting the price of the security to be 2200. So purchasing the security at 2000 and selling at 2200 will end up with the profit once again. That is the reason that X is offering like this to Mr. Y. Mr. Y thinks about it and afterwards Mr. Y says that no, I am not interested in this transaction. Mr. X says and say, you have all the reasons to believe that price will be 2200. I have offered you to buy the security at 2000. So you purchase security at 2000. You sell the security at 2200. So you will end up with a profit of 200. However, Mr. Y says that, see, I agree with you that say, if at all my expectation proves to be correct, I will make a profit. However, if at all the price of the security is falling down substantially because the market is uncertain, so if at all the price of the security will fall down substantially, I will be incurring a huge loss. Let's say, suppose price of the security reduces to ₹1100. Then what will happen? Purchasing the security at 2000 and which has a value of 1100 will result into a loss of 900 only. So I do not want to take that risk. Like that, sir, Mr. Y says that, say, no, I am not interested. So now Mr. X says something like this. Listen carefully. Mr. X says like this. Mr. X again offers to Mr. Y that let us enter into a contract in which you may purchase security from me at the rate of 2000 on 31st of January. To purchase this right from me comma, you have to pay rupees 80 to me today on 1st of January. So Mr. X offers that to Y, that let us enter into a contract in which you may purchase security from me at 2000 on 31st of January. To purchase this right from me, you have to pay 80 rupees to me today on 1st of January. Mr. X thinks about it. I'm sorry, Mr. Y thinks about this offer. And Mr. Y says, I'd say, yes, I'm ready for it. Now, on 31st of January, suppose spot price of the security is, let us say, an amount of 2500. Let us say it is an amount of 2050. And let us say it is an amount of 1500. For each of the spot price, I want you to tell me that what would be the overall profit or loss. What would be overall profit or loss to Mr. Y for entering into this transaction? For each price, you tell me, let's say, what would be the profit or loss to Mr. Y? Let us see, let's say, how to do answer. We understand like this. Calculation of profit or loss to Mr. Y will be calculated like this. Spot price of the security on 31st of January. Sale price, purchase price, then a kind of payoff, and the last is the profit or loss. And in between, that's the exercise, question mark. Everybody is requested to pay attention. On 31st of January, spot price is 2500 provided, then 2050 is provided, then 1500 is provided. We understand that Sir Mr. Y has a right to purchase the security at the rate of 2000. Mr. Y is having a right to purchase the security at the rate of rupees 2000. So when the price is greater than 2000, he will exercise his right. Greater than 2000, he will exercise his right. If it is lower than 2000, then in that case, he will not exercise his right. If at all he will exercise his right, then in that case, he will purchase a security at 2000 to be sold at 2500. So there is a payoff of 500, and initially an amount of 80 was paid to buy the right. So the final profit or loss is 420. That is 500 minus 80. In the second case also, the right is exercised. So you buy the security at 2000. You sell at 2500, you sell at 2050, so you have a payoff of 15 and there is a loss of 30 rupees. How this 30 is calculated? 50 minus 80. Last, in that case you do not exercise your right. So whatever the 80 rupees that you had paid initially is an amount of the loss that we have. This is what we understand is a kind of profit or loss that Mr. Y will have. Now let us have understanding, friends. Whatever this transaction that we have understood, friends, is given a technical name as the option transaction. Now what do we understand with the term option transaction? Let us understand. option transaction stands for? Simple, option means right. The term option stands for, or the term option means right. Option trading means trading of right. One is the purchaser of right and another is seller of right. Who is purchaser of the right? Purchaser of the right is option purchaser and seller of right is the option seller. The example that say we have seen in that, say Mr. Y is option purchaser and Mr. X is option seller. Friends, there are two types of option that we have. One is given a name as the call option and another is given a name as put option. Like that, say there are two types of option. What do we understand with the term call option? The call option has a simple meaning like this. Listen carefully what I am going to speak. Call option means an option that entitles holder of option to purchase underlying asset. The example that we have seen is of the call option. The example that we have seen is of the call option in which Mr. Y is having, say, a right to purchase the underlying asset. What is the price at which he can buy the underlying asset? He can buy the underlying asset at the rate of 2000 and that 2000 is given a name as the exercise price. Price at which underlying asset can be purchased is called exercise price. Or it is also given a name as strike price. So over here we understand that in this example, Mr. Y was having, say, a right to purchase the underlying asset at the rate of 2000. So the price at which you are having, say, the right to purchase underlying asset is given a technical name as the exercise price or strike price. In option transaction, option buyer will pay upfront premium to option seller, comma, to purchase right. Full stop. Friends, in case of option transactions, what will happen? Option buyer, in this example, we understand that it is like Mr. Y, is required to make payment of upfront premium because nothing is available free of cost. So over here, an upfront premium is required to be paid in order to, say, purchase the right. That is what we understand is 80 rupees is the premium which is supposed to be paid on upfront basis. This is what, say, we understand. And so this is the way the call option works.
We understand friends like this further. In case of option transaction, option buyer has right to exercise his right. So only option buyer has right to exercise his right. In case of call option holder will exercise his right, comma, if spot price is exceeding the exercise price. So if at all the spot price is exceeding the exercise price, then in that case the call option holder will exercise his right. Else option is allowed to be lapsed. This is what we understand. I am having a question to all of you that say, as far as the option holder is concerned, what is the amount of the maximum loss that the option holder will have? Everyone answered very correctly. That said, the option holder will have the maximum loss equal to the option premium. In no case the loss will exceed the premium which has been paid. Because if at all the option is not worth exercising, then in that case you allow the option to lapse. That is the reason, so the maximum loss is equal to, so the option premium. Friends, we are going to discuss the put option in the time to come. Right now we are focusing on the call option. I am dictating first of all a note to you and then we'll do a numerical. Heading right down, option contract. Heading right down, option contract. In that write down, first point, option means right. Full stop. Option trading means trading of right. Full stop. Second, in an option transaction, comma, there are two traders. Full stop. A, option buyer, B, option seller. Third point, option buyer will make payment of upfront premium to purchase right. Full stop. Right can be exercised at the rate exercise price. Full stop. In bracket write down strike price. Fourth point, importantly, option buyer will exercise his right if it is favorable for him to do so. Full stop. Hence, option buyer will have a maximum loss equal to option premium. Fifth point, option seller will have maximum profit equal to option premium. Sixth point. Friends, I'm dictating the sixth point to you. However, this point we are going to discuss later on. At this point of time, I'm discussing because of the reason that I want to have a proper note from your revision point of view. Sixth point. With respect to exercisation, comma, there are two types of option. A, European, and B, American. Like that, so there are two types of option. What is this European American? We are going to discuss that later on. New heading write down, call option. In that write down, first point, call option gives option holder / option buyer right to purchase underlying asset. Full stop. What is the price that we already have written earlier? Exercise price. Second, call option holder will exercise his right, comma, if spot price exceeds exercise price. slash strike price. Full stop.